Thank you. Always finishing touch. Oh. Very good. Kirtan. Vidyapati. Mahaprabhu is Gambhira. He used to hear his songs. Vidyapati Chandidas or Gita Govinda. He likes so much. Advaitacharya Prabhu met me in Mithila. He was a Rajkavi of Mithila, king. What? He was?
Royal poet.
When Advaitacharya Prabhu Brajamandal, he went to Mithila Janakpuri. He saw that in a shade of Kadamba banyan tree, very, very beautiful but old, any person is lying down and singing with tears. तातल सैकत भारी बिंदु सम सुतमित रमणी समाजी वीपिंग वेरी डीप मीनिंग्स हाउ रेचड आई एम फाई ऑन मी आई हैव फॉरगेटन कृष्णा माय एटर्नल मास्टर आई एम सिंकिंग इन वर्ल्डली डिजायर्स What? Wife, children and all these things. What they will do? Oh Prabhu, you should be merciful to me like this. Advaitacharya thought that who is Mahapurush? And then he sat down and then he asked. Then he was weeping and bitterly. Whole life I have done king seva, rajya kavi. But now I am realizing what bogus things I had. He wrote so many Krishna poems, so many. Very, very virahatmaka.
Full of separation.
That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu liked. Also, Chandidas. Oh, high-class kavi. One day, tomorrow, we can produce any kirtan. You know Chandidas? Keva sunaila Krishna naam. You should see and... Now.
Yeah.
अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरद्विजे नमः गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय यं प्राव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेदो तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि तया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम चरणान्तिके फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल माय मिलियंस ऑफ दंडक प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर परमाराध्य तम ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज एंड सेम मिलियंस ऑफ दंडक प्रणाम इन द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय शिक्षा गुरु नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद श्रीमद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज टुडे इन मॉर्निंग और गोवर्धन पूजा गो पूजा वैष्णव पूजा वेरी वंडरफुल मोर देन 750 टन्स ऑफ
800
वंडरफुल आई प्रे गोवर्धन दोज हु होल नाइट प्रिपेयरिंग all these things so many paraphernalia and those who helped them those who brought all these things to make and those who took all in their head and went there and those who saw how offering how beautiful abhishek and then aarti bhog Go puja and everything. Those who have seen, really they are very lucky. The mercy of Govardhan Prabhu, Govardhan Giriraj, certainly they have, they will receive. And those who are thinking, this is bogus thing. What? We should speak so much. All this Harikatha, no need of going to Govardhan Puja. Are where your Guru is going? All Vaishnava are going. What we told there? Paramadamadana Leela Kandare Kandare Te Rachayati Navajunu Dvanda Masmin Namandam इतिकिल नकल नार्तक लग्न कस्त दयोर में निज निकट निवासम दे गोवर्धन ओ गोवर्धन की राज इज विटनेस फॉर ऑल द हिडन स्वीट पास्ट टाइम्स कुंज लीला ओ गिरिराज गोवर्धन यू शुड इंस्पायर ऑल दिस लीला यत्रैव कृष्णो विषभानुपुत्रा दानं गृहीतुं कलहं वितेने सुते स्पृहा जत्र महत् सहतासे गोवर्धनो में शीशतम ओ गिरिराज गोवर्धन वेर इन गोवर्धन इन दान घाटी यू आर गोपीज आर एंड यू सो बेस्ट डायलॉग्स एंड दे आर क्वारलिंग prema kalaha, love quarrel. Gopis are telling, who are you to take taxes here? Is it your father's property? Oh, Krishna told, oh, yes, this is my wife's property. Who is your wife? Oh, Brinda. Oh, they called Brinda and told, oh, Brinde, you are wife of this black person? And then what? She told, never, never. He thinks that I am husband of all Braja Gopi. But who will marry to this cheater person and black person? Then Krishna, Gopi told, have you planted any plant here? Even? We think that by your cows, or destroying all the creepers here, grasses here, flowers here. So how you became like this? And to take tax, so kalhang vitene, sutesh pihar jatra mahattatah sri govardhano me jishatam avishtam. Oh, Govardhan Giriraj, oh, fulfill my desire. What is your desire? Oh, very high, very high. What even tell? Oh, Radha Darsham. Very, very rare. Achha, yes. Oh.
So be kya? It. So be it. So be it.
Tathastu. 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 That. Jataiva Ganga Manu Navi Radha Arohya Madhe. Oh, Krishna. Being a boatman. Oh, come on. Now it is very dark going. Come on my boat. I will very soon
cross.
Take a cross.
And then, when all sat there, oh, my boat is very old. And water is coming. Oh, so give up your all jars. Water jars. They gave up.
Pitchers.
So Krishna was telling so many things and began to
rock about.
And then Srimati Radhika automatically catch hold of him, what Krishna wanted. So, oh Giriraj, you are?
Eye witness.
So, please inspire us in that pastimes. How beautiful Govardhan. Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, himself he used to go and tell all these poetries. One I don't remember, of one of Rup Goswami, one of
Das Goswami,
and one of Vishwanath Chakravarti. This is the mantra of Govardhan Puja. So don't think these are not important. Only Hari Katha that. Then yesterday, we heard about Navjogendra last, and he finished Karbhajan Rishi in the end. After, in Kali Yuga, Mahaprabhu is worshipful deity. I buy Sankirtan, or his worship is Sankirtan Mahajagya. And then Narad went to other planets. After that, Brahma, with Shankar, Indra, Angira, and other Vidyadhar, Gandharva, and all, they came to Dwarka to take darshan of Krishna. And they began to pray Krishna. And when they prayed, then they told, Brahma told, O Supreme Lord, we prayed that take the burden of earth. So in childhood, you killed Agasur, Bakasur, Putana, Keshi, and so many. And in Mathura, Charun, mostly Kansa. And after that in Dwarka, Jarasandha, Kaljaman, Pandit Vasudev, and so many. And after that, in Mahabharata, you became charioteer. Arjun and Bhim were fighting and killing. But really, you, main cause. Why? You used to take their all
energy
and strongness. And they become what? Like zero. And Arjun Bhim, he became Nimitta Karanamaldi. But really, Krishna. In this way, so many Akshahani army of these wicked kings were finished. Or then, Prabhu, now we request that our whole desire is fulfilled. And you came to taste Braja Rasa. You also have tasted that. That to hear Kalyugi Manushya, Kalyugi human
beings,
human persons, they will very easily by hearing, by telling, very easily they will cross the unlimited pain of birth and life and receive your Hari Prem. So now we requesting, if you like, we cannot order you. If you like, then your all desire, all our desire have been fulfilled. Now you can go to your
abode.
Paramdham,
abode.
Brajamandal. Krishna told me, I was thinking like so. Now my all desires have been finished and burden of earth has been removed. So I was thinking, and in the meantime you have come. But I want to tell you, everything has been done, but not everything. Something is
remaining.
And that is that my Yaduvansa, very desperate, protected by me, any demigods, Indra and others, cannot defeat them. So if I will go, this very desperate Yaduvansi will be a burden of this whole world. Oh, now Brahmasap has come very soon. What was Brahmasap? Once Durvasa, Narad, Gautam, Vasishta, or so many high class of rishis and muni, they went to take darshan of Krishna. And after darshan, very near or anywhere, they were sitting and they were discussing the glories of Krishna. In the meantime, all Yaduvansi boys, young persons, they thought, what they rishi are? They don't know anything. They decorated Shamb, one of the son of Krishna, very beautiful, more than ladies. And decorating like a lady, and they put some cloths on the stomach of that Shamb. And after that one tawa,
like
on which bread is given, they gave. And they took it to Rishi Maharshi. Sambha's whale. They, depressed boys, went there and told, Rishi Maharshi, you know Bhut, Bhavishyat, Vartaman. You know present, past and future. So we are requesting that this lady is very shy, very shy. But she wants to know that she is pregnant, so a boy or daughter will come from her. First they neglected rishis. What these boys are telling. But again and again they told like this, then they became very angry and told, no son, no daughter, a musal will come, upside wood and lower side some iron. Oh, this musal will come and it will destroy your whole dynasty. Oh, they became very worried. At once running, they opened and they saw, oh, really, a musal is there. Then they took that musal. They did not went to Krishna, they went to Ugrasena. Told, oh, Maharaj, oh, we are very worried that we went to rishis and they became angry and they had told like this. Oh, you have done very wrong thing. And then he took that musal. Wooden part was burnt in fire into ashes. And iron, they began to
grind.
Crush. Then it became like dust, but some was not crushed. Then he took all the ashes of wood and all the iron dust and that remaining part of iron, and he fell in the ocean. At once, ocean does not keep anything. If you fell anything, it will return back. If you go there, oh, he will take your life and your body he may
return.
No more. So all the dust of that iron, they came again in the shore and they become irka grass. Very sharp, very big, about 15 feet high or more, and very sharp, his lips very sharp. And that remaining part of iron was a fish
swallowed
out. And after some time,
A fisherman
caught that fish, and he saw, when he was going to cook, he saw that a very sharp iron part is there. He took it and
put
on his barn,
arrow,
on the end of the arrow. Now, by this sharp
curse
of rishis, now was appearing. Krishna told all Jadvansi, we should not stay here more. You see that from the sky, rain of
blood
is coming. So many unauspicious things are going on. Jackals and crows and elephants are weeping. So we should not stay a moment here. At once we should go to Prabhas, and there Prabhas is very holy place. There we will make sacrifices and we will worship Brahmins and we will satisfy that Brahmas. By that our course may be reduced, otherwise not. So we must go there. He was telling, and in the meantime Uddhav came. Oh Prabhu, I was searching you. You are sitting here. What I am seeing, so many unauspicious things,
Oh, Brahma Shap is on our head. I know that you are Supreme Lord. You can stop that course. You can make remedy for that. But I am seeing that you are supporting the Brahmans. Supporting, okay? Yes. Supporting. In your opinion, oh, the Brahma Shap is okay. But by these symptoms, I know that now you want to give up this world and want to go to Param Brahmapad, Golok Vrindavan Retreat. So please, I cannot remain without you. From boyhood we have played together. Sometimes you have taken my advice. You are Supreme Lord, but I am Vishai. But even you took my advice. I am now Mukdho Rahu.
Bewildered
now. Please, Prabhu, I want to come with you. Don't give up me. Then Krishna told, I want that you should be in this world. After me, Kalji will come. And so many bad things will come. After me, you will be the representative. And by these sweet pastimes, you can tell to others. Only you are
qualified.
So please be here. He told them, how can I be here? I'm bewildered. A man like me, so Vishai attached to all friends and others.
Relatives, family members.
How I can be here? Then Krishna told, I'm telling a story. Please hear. And then he began to tell that, you know, Maharaj Jadu, very wise and very powerful king of Jadu dynasty. Once he was going anywhere and he saw a man who was quite naked. And he was so happy. He had nothing with him, empty-handed, and very prafulla chitta.
Very happy
mood. He was traveling whole world. Nothing to do from others. Then Jadu Maharaj did pranam to him. Oh Prabhu, I see that you are not ordinary person. You know past, present and future. Always so happy. And traveling whole world. Naked quite. Not even a langoti. Why? How? Then he became he left his moan bow.
Silence.
He broke his silence.
And by mercy, he began to tell him. What he began to tell him? 24 Guru, 24 Gurus. I have done 24 Gurus. And what they are? You can begin. You have not? You remember?
तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः. First of all, I pay my humble obeisances on the lotus feet of my Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma, Om Vishnu Pad, Ashtodara Satasishtimad Bhaktivedanta Shri Bhavan Goswami Maharaj, and Om Vishnu Pad, Paribrajak Acharya Varja, Ashtodara Satasishtimad Bhaktivedanta Shri Narayan Goswami Maharaj. I pay my obeisances all Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis who assembled here to listen some Harikatha from Gurudev Lotus Lips, headed by Tridhani Sannyasis. So, Srila Gurudev has discussed about Uddhava Sangvad. So, prior to that, when discussion was going on between Uddhava and Krishna, Uddhava understood that Krishna will give up this material world and will go his eternal abode, Golok Dham. Uddhava told, O Prabhu, what you are advising me to give up all relatives and friends. So what you are telling is not proper for me because I am Vishayi. I am thinking all these things. So what sannyas you are telling to give up? So how I can easily get rid of this thing? Moreover, in this world, all are swept by your material energy, means illusory maya. Very hard to get rid of this maya. But you have told, ye yathamang prapadante maya metam tarantite. So I don't care for your maya. I am not fearing for your maya. I am fearing for your separation. How I will be here without you? You are my soulmate. You are my life and soul. Without you, my life in vain. So what shall I do? Then Uddhava told, Tayopa Bhukta Sagganda Vasa, what your remnant cloth, sandal paste, and garland and your cloth I am using. Using all these things, I can get it very easily. Because I am your das, but I am not fearing for your maya, fearing for your separation. So please tell me, how I'll be happy can get rid of all these things which you are telling. Then Krishna told, listen, in our dynasty there is a very influential king named Yadu. Once he was traveling, then he saw one avadhut. And he's very happy and always keeping silence mood, of keeping silence. Seeing him, Yadu Maharaj did pranam to him because in ancient time, they used to honor the Brahmin always. So told, O Prabhu, it seems that you are very happy because face is the indication of mind. Your face is very happy. So what kind of pleasure you have in your heart that you are very happy? You are very qualified to do any karma, but not doing any karma. What is the cause that you became very happy? Then, seeing his polite mood, Avadhut means Dattatreyaji has broken his silence and being causeless merciful, told to him, oh, so listen carefully. In my life, I met so many persons, so many living entities. From them, I learned so many things. I met 24 gurus, siksha gurus. From them, what I learned, I am telling you, so you can listen carefully. I have learned from Mother Earth, Prithivi Devi, and Agni, Akash, Vayu, Moon, Sun, Pigeon, so many things, 24. The first one, Mother Earth. In this earth, so many persons doing so many nonsense things, but he's so much tolerant, always forgive mode. Look, we are not doing any worship of Mother God. We are sitting here. We are walking on top of that, on the earth surface, and we are digging hole, we are passing stool, passing urine, and in this modern Kali, So many they are doing, so many nuclear tests, so many things they are doing. But he never
protest.
Always calm and quiet, tolerating everything. So from Mother Earth, I learned how to tolerate and the quality of forgiveness. Listen, the trees and mountain, they came from Earth. If you see trees, they never alive for their own. Then everything, their root, their bark, their wood, their leaf, their flower and fruits, everything for others. So if someone wants to do bhajan, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told for whole world, Trinadopi Sunichena, Taroropi Sahishnuna, Amanina Manudena, Kirtaniya Sadahari. When Sarva Damodar Prabhu and Raya Ramananda Prabhu was discussing with Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu told, Kirupe Loile Nam Prem Upajay, Tahar Sarub Lakhan Suna Ram Rai. Mahaprabhu is telling, O Sarub Ram, Sarub Ramananda, Sarub Damodar Ramananda, by which process someone will accept Harinam, how they attain Prem, I am telling you. Then Mahaprabhu told, Trinadopi Sunichena Taroropi Sahishnuna. We have to be very humble than a piece of blade of a grass. And if you walk on that grass, they will not protest you. And Taroropi Sahishnuna have to be more tolerant than a tree. If there is full of fruits, if you hit the tree by a stick or by a stone, they will protest you. You are giving pain, they are giving you very nice, tasty, and not, by which you can nourish your life, they are giving fruit. So Vaishnava have to be like this, and not hankering for his own prestige, have to give prestige to others. So here, Yadu Maharaj, I was telling to Yadu Maharaj, that trees, they are living for others, not for them. And mountain also. So from Prithivi Devi, from Mother Earth, I learned how to give forgiveness. After that he told, my second guru is
wind.
Bayu. Wind, air is two types. One is live air, another external air. The first one, live air, living inside, is not desiring anything. Only what he needs, by that we can eat, by his desire. If there is no life here, we could not eat, could not alive. And so Krishna has told in Gita also, yuktahara viharascha. What is needed if you use that, then you will be yogi, then will not affect by other mode of natures. So this life here, instructing us, don't be attached, and what is needed, you can use that only. And outside air, you have to go everywhere. You can see air is here now, going there, traveling here and there. Although they are traveling, they want or not, they have to take so many things like good fragrant or foul smell, you want or not. But the fragrant is the quality of earth, but still air have to take in. And from here is going, then give up here, not taking other place. He always completely detached. Same way, who is sadhak? They have to detach from this material world. We have, if needed, have to go so many places, but don't attach there, like air. So I have learned all this, how to be detached, I learned this from air. After that he told, my third guru is...
Akash.
Sky. Na, Jol.
Sky.
Huh. Bayu Akash.
Oh. The third guru is
sky.
The sky also always detached everywhere. Inside any pot, outside, inside our body, everywhere, but always detached, not attached anywhere. So from Akasa I have learned how to be nearly, how to be detached. After he told my fourth guru is water.
Even Akash, it seems that rain is coming and clouds are covering sky. But really not so. Akash is always nirmal.
Always clean and clear.
Those clouds and so many rain and everything is there. But he is not quite disturbed. Nirmal. So a sadhu should be like that.
Then he told, my fourth guru is water. Water always transparent and pure. And it's very smooth and sweet taste. So sadhak must be always pure and very transparent. Means his external and internal behavior will be same. That means be simple hearted without any hypocrite. You are telling one thing and behind thinking another thing, not like this. And always be or use sweet word for others. If someone come, if he could not treat them nicely or could not welcome nicely, at least you can use your sweet words. What harm if you use sweet words? So sadhak must be always use sweet words and pure and transparent. Externally and internally be same.
Also, about wind, always pure. Sometimes it blows from
one part to another part.
No.
Sugandha. Good
Durgandha.
Foul smell.
Bad smell.
Bad smell and so many things. And sometimes goes through a very far, very good forest smelling flowers and no, but see, vayu is always
neutral.
Nothing to do. And in the same way,
sky
is always nirmal. So a sadhu should be like that. Good man, bad man, so many things coming, meeting him, but he will be always nirmal. Nothing to do with others. Go on.
After that, he told, my another guru is fire. From fire, I have learned that fire eating everything. If you put anything in fire, any good thing or bad thing, you take everything, but not be contaminated. So sadhu,
digest
everything. Fire digest everything. So sadhu must be like fire. What is needed he can do, but must be always pure. He should not keep inside anything him. If you keep anything inside you, then you will contaminate it. If you digest, then no problem. You are eating but could not digest, then your stomach problem, this and that. But fire digesting everything and you not taking any good or bad quality of others. So sadhu can mix others, but they should not take any good or bad qualities of material world, then their sadhana will be hampered. So this way I have learned so many things from so many gurus. There are 24 gurus, so we have heard from others and from Guru Lotus Leaf. Hare Krishna.
You, Ravi,
Sun,
and then Kapot, then Ajigar.
Om Jnanati Varandhasya Jnanandana Salakaya Chakshuran Vithandena Tasvai Sikurave Nama. First of all, I have for my Sastani Dhanavad Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands of times with the lotus feet of Asmadhyaya Paramaradhyaya Tum Guru Pada Padma Om Vishnu Pada Stotra Vasita Sishimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. I have for my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Varga, Sri Guru Parampara, and offer my pranam to all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. So, Srila Gurudev ordered me to continue with the narration of Dattatreya, spoken by Dattatreya, explaining how he is looking around the world and being inspired and learning so many lessons from his Drishtanta Gurus, the gurus that teach by seeing them and by their examples. So Dattatreya, he explained, fire is my guru. Why? Because fire is changing at every moment. All the small particles in the fire are moving all the time, but you cannot see it. So in the same way, all the shapes in the world around us, they are changing at every moment by the imperceptible movements of time, and finally everything will be vanquished. So from fire, I have learned about the imperceptible movement of time. We forget that life is going by very, very quickly. But every year when we come here to have the darshan of Srila